So it hasn't released in Japan yet. Neither season have released in Japan yet. So he doesn't know, you know, how the Japanese audience will react.
Maku, since we have two new seasons of FLCL now, what about another new season of Ghost in the Shell Standalone Complex?
Yeah, there's you know, hopes that people, I mean, like, people have been asking about it, and we are we are making the new season for Ghost in the Shell. It's 13 episodes and 13 episodes, so there's two seasons.
Oh, wow.
Right? And a total of 26 episodes, and the first season is directed by Kenji Kamiyama, who is also the director of Standalone Complex. The second season, I don't know, it's the first season or the second season?
いや、26エピソード、24エピソードなの。
でもその最初のがシーズン1、そうじゃないですか。
うん、
最初の神山さん
の。うん、だ、そうだね。
We're not actually like we, you know, we're still like in development, so we don't quite know the names of like how we're gonna call the first half and the second half. But it's 12 episodes and 12 episodes, a total of 24. You know, that's still like still indecisive. But one batch is directed by Kenji Kamiyama, who's the director of Standalone Complex. The other batch is directed by Shinji Aramaki, who's the director of Apple.
Arigato gozaimasu. And for Ishikawa sensei, now that we have three seasons of Fuli Kuli, how about three more? So we have six in the movie.
あのやっぱりでもフリクリはやっぱりそのすごくこうロックだからロックの魂で作ってるからやっぱりそのやっぱり妥協しちゃいけないっていうのがフリクリのいつもロック魂で来るんで、あのまたねその気持ちが湧いた時に作れるんで、今はもうヘトヘトなんでね、もうやりきったって感じだから、今まあ今のところまだ全然感じます。
So pretty pretty, like as you can see, it has a very rock and roll spirit, right? So like we let everything out, we, you know, we go all out. So we just finished 2 and 3, so we're very tired. So, you know, it's not like we're gonna be able to like move on to, you know, the new season just as of yet. We just finished the 2 seasons. So, but you know, we'll see. Like there may not be. We'll see where it goes.
I know one of the most important things for Furikuri was keeping the spirit alive of the series. Obviously bringing Haruko back. Fans wanted to, are we going to get to see even in the next season more of characters we haven't seen from the first season and everything?
Yes, absolutely. I don't want to spoil anything, but you can almost treat it as like a different story, different timeline and all that. I mean, just like how Furikuri 2 is different from Furikuri 1, Haruko is in all the seasons, but we're going to be introducing a completely new set of characters for season 3.
With those new characters, it's compared from seasons 1, 2, and 3, it's always been different age groups, and seeing how they, it always feels like a coming of age story,
yes,
and then coming to their own, which was always something that resonated with me watching the first series.
Yes.
How has it been visiting these different kind of age ranges in seasons 2 and 3?
Is there a question for me or
for both
of them? その思春期を経験する子どもたちこれなんて話せばいいと思うんですけど、なんかクリエイターが自分で経験したことをなんかちょっとお話に盛り込んでるみたいな。
そうだね。でも基本的には春子は年齢層の中で一応19歳があって、でフリクリ1っていうのは小学校なんだね。13歳だから、だから13小学校で、フリクリ2は中学校なんだね。でフリクリ3は高校生で、やっぱりその監督が思春期で一番感じた年齢でこう作っていくっていうのが一番大事なので、一応だから小学校とか大人になる、で中学校からもでもまだ子供のような大人になってる、で高校の時は微妙なんだよね。だからそういう大人になる手前のところを 小学校の視点、中学校の視点、高校生の視点で、それなおかつ19歳のある子もいるって、これはクリクリの、あのバランスだと思う。
So not that 1, 2, and 3 are all chronological, but 1 deals with children in, you know, who are going to elementary school, and then they go through the coming of age. And then season 2 is the children are junior high, and then season 3 is high school. So the way they go through, you know, puberty and coming of age is different, you know. So one is talked from the stance of grade school children. Second is from the perspective of the junior high. So the directors all, you know, everybody goes through all that, you know, the coming of age. So they individually was able to look back their past and incorporate what, how they felt at that, you know, time of those scenes and whatnot. So they were able to incorporate some of their personal experiences in all both of the seasons.
And if I may, was it a conscious decision for seasons 2 and 3 to base it off of female characters as the main leads as opposed to Nalta in the first season? Or is that just something that came out of the stories that you wanted to tell?
We gave the creators, like, you know, as much freedom as possible, because that's what we did for the original Pretty Pretty. So it wasn't really like, you know, we gave them a certain perimeter to work within, but whether the main characters are going to be a boy or a girl, you know, it was pretty much up to them. Jason and I talked, and Ishika talked about it, and since season 1 was about Nauta, we thought that maybe season 2 or 3 would be interesting to base it on a female character. And then I guess the, you know, some of the directors thought that would be also interesting, or maybe they already had that in mind before we even suggested to them. So it wasn't something that we pushed them, we just allowed them to come up with their own unique ideas, and that's how it ended up happening.
For Ishikawa sensei, the Pirate King,
Atomsk.
Do you see him as sort of like this untamed spirit of like rock and roll or music at all? Or is that like, is he a more abstract metaphor?
そこが今回のテーマであって、これあえてそのアトムスか何かっていうのを言わないことにすることで、ブルクリっていう世界観を感じてもらうっていう話なので、
He has his own opinions, but then like he doesn't want to, you know, disclose it here because it's pretty much up to the viewers to decide like what they think Atomus is, and then that is sort of like the overall theme of all of the Atomus franchise. Yeah.
So Haruko's a very unique and wild character. So going into season 2, what did you want to change about her character while still keeping her similar to what she was in the first season?
Haruko is almost like an unchanged, you know, but like in season 2 and 3, Haruko's personalities differ slightly. In my opinion, like maybe season 3, Haruko is a little bit more caring than the crazy Haruko in 2 or 1. But like she's almost like a, in season 3, she serves almost as an educational purpose to the characters. I don't know how much of that like you should write, because again, it's gonna be like a spoiler.
Of course.
Yeah, but Haruko っていうキャラクターっていうのは1、2、3を通じて変わって、あの成長していってるっていうのは、でも常に Haruko っていうのは同じ。
いや、成長してないんだ。もう何百年経ってるかって分からない設定だから、そこに関してはいつまで Haruko は19歳の、っていうのを変えないっていうのが Haruko のキャラクター。
性格も変わらない。
そう、うん、変わらない。強い。
In his opinion, like she's like you know, unchanged. She doesn't change. Like she's not a human, you know. So she always stays 19 years old. You know, she may be living for 100 years, but then like she's always 19, and her personality, her stance, nothing changes.
Haruko はだって19歳で、ああいう性格だから、あと他のキャラクター、小学生は全部こういろんなキャラクターがいるから、ハルコはブレちゃうと、作品全体がブレちゃうから、ハルコだけは変わらないけど、周りはどうか。
She always has to stay at like the center of the circle because like everything else around her changes, but she needs to be kind of like in the center, the axis of everything around it, because if she starts changing, then everything starts changing.
any of you guys have? I think we just have 1 minute left.
Yeah, we have one question left.
Yeah, go ahead. In that case, I just wanted to ask you, with respect to the pillows being back for the music in the series, the version of My Foot that played during this particular episode, it was a new recording, if I'm not mistaken. How much of the music for both of the newest seasons was newly recorded?
The only new songs that they actually composed and created for season 2 and 3 are the ending theme.
Okay.
So season 2 was Spiky Seas, right? And then season 3 is Stars Overhead. Yeah.
Okay.
So all the other music that we used in season 2 and 3 are the existing Pillows music.
Okay, thanks. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you guys.
Season.
We're going to